Our cities grow bigger and bigger, but they cannot cope with this growth. 180,000 people flock to cities every day, but they find no adequate housing and often no work. Those that succeed often waste energy for things that they hate to do, such as commuting. In cities and suburbs alike, pollution is increased by the construction of unsound housing and unhealthy lifestyles. Premature deaths due to unhealthy environment cost lives and stress our health system. Wildfires and floods destroy human and natural habitats alike. The way we live and build cities today is not sustainable. What had begun as a good plan with the Greek polis grew into metropolis with industrialization and into a megalopolis with globalization. Soon, these megacities will become dinopolis. Life in these urban dinosaurs is affected by high cost of living and, as a consequence, dominated by a rat race for jobs and salaries, stress and constant traffic jams. Instead of doing what we love to do, we run around like hamsters on a treadmill. We waste too much energy, nerves, time, and health for sheer survival in today's cities. We must find a solution to these problems. And I think we found one. I'm Andreas Binkert. I'm an architect and urban developer in Switzerland. And I would like to share the solution with you. 20 years ago, at ETH Zurich, my alma mater, we came up with a development framework for sustainable urban development, which we termed the 2000-watt society. The 2000-watt society fights climate change by focusing on the issue of energy waste and efficient energy use. And most important to me personally, it states that each human being should have equal rights to energy and climate gas emissions. In the 2000-watt society, we meet in the middle. Developed countries must reduce their hunger for energy and their greenhouse gas emission. Emerging countries can prosper and build up their economies. Unfortunately, this egalitarian vision is far from today's reality. In developed economies, we use up to 10,000 watts per person. Meanwhile, in developing countries, less than a tenth of that is available per person. Can we meet at 2,000? Yes, we can. We formed a team of experts and invented guidelines and monitoring systems to certify and control the performance of existing neighborhoods and greenfield developments alike, and designed Green City Zurich, the first carbon-neutral neighborhood in Switzerland. Over the last 10 years, we certified 38 such projects in Switzerland, and now we are developing and certifying similar projects in India. We don't certify buildings. We certify the symbiosis amongst man, between man and nature, and between equality and prosperity. This certificate is truly sustainable. Green City Zurich taught us that in order to build the city of the future, we must focus on communities and neighborhoods, or as the French call them, the 15 minutes city. They will become the most important ingredient of the 2000-watt city. They are small but dense, contain all you need for daily life, and are well connected amongst each other. If they wish, people can comfortably move from one to the other through lush green fields and forests, but they do not need to do so daily. No more commutes, no more traffic hassle, no more lost quality time. Everything is within walking distance. Fun, shopping, work, home, kindergartens, and medical centers, you name it. You don't believe that it is possible? Well, pretty soon all of Switzerland will be a 2000-watt smart city. But would such a vision also work in emerging economies? Would it work in Pune, where we are currently certifying the first Indian project, the Symbiosis International University Campus? Pune district is roughly about half the size of Switzerland. If it was to become a 2000-watt city, connectivity would have to be improved. Towns would have to be complementing their facilities. Existing neighborhoods would have to be densified and new ones developed. And all of that would have to be realized fast, much faster than Switzerland built its environment and settlements. But would that be possible? Well, we worked with three generations of Pune Metro Region Development Commissioners. And as a result, the new Pune Development Plan is made to suit the requirements of the 2000-watt concept. And first master plans are already being discussed. The concept is scalable, bankable, and profitable. If it works in Pune, it will work in other places throughout India, and it can be adapted to anywhere around the globe. So, what are we waiting for? Let's build the cities of the future. Let's build 2000-watt smart cities.